Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Android Studio on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to use Android Studio for creating Android projects. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in the middle, you can always ask me on comment sessions. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install Android Studio, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, Android Studio download, hit enter. So that will show you this developer.android.com. So just simply go to their official site. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. Once when you are here, you will see that latest version of Android Studio at the time of making of this video is Android Studio version Meerkat. So you're going to download this latest version. So when I click on this download button, it's going to show you these terms and conditions. You need to scroll down and then you need to check this and then you need to click on download Android Studio. So that will immediately going to start downloading our Android Studio. You can see it slightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that our Android Studio version Meerkat, that is version 2024.3.1.13, it's already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 1.22 gigabyte. So it is quite a big file, I must say. So now to install, you need to just simply double click on the installer, and that will show you this verifying installer. Locks you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go. Welcome to Android Studio setup. So let's first minimize our download directory, and here just simply click on next. So here it is giving you a couple of options. One is Android virtual device. So I always recommend you to uncheck that, because we are going to use our Android phone itself for running our Android apps that we are going to create. So I recommend you to uncheck that, because we don't need to have a virtual device installed on our laptop. All right. So that's going to unnecessarily occupy a lot of space on our drive and going to make our system slow. So that's why I recommend you, you know, to uncheck that, because every one of you almost using at least one Android phone, right? So you can use that phone itself for, you know, creating any Android projects and to run that right on your phone. So I'm going to show you all of that in the coming part of the video. So just keep watching this video. All right. So first uncheck this and click on next. So this is where our Android Studio is going to be installed. Totally fine. Click on next. So it's going to create Android Studio folder, totally fine, click on install. So immediately we'll see it is rightly started installing. So let's wait for some time and there you go. So you can see that our installation is complete. So just simply click on next. So now it is telling whether you'd like to start Android Studio. So just, you know, keep it default and click on finish. So that's going to start launching our Android Studio. So you can see that our Android Studio version Meerkat is rightly started launching. And then it's going to start downloading some of the add-ons. And once that is done, it's going to show you this welcome note. So just simply click on next over here. So here under installation types, there are a couple of options. One is standard and custom. I will always recommend you to select custom and proceed with the next part of installation. So select custom and click on next. Here see, it has these couple of options called Android virtual device and performance Android emulator. We don't need any virtual device, as I told you at the very beginning of the video, because it's going to, you know, take a lot of space on our drive. All right, so we don't need that, because we'll use our phone itself. All right, so that's why you need to uncheck both these two options. And you need to just simply click on next. So everything is fine. Click on next. Here you need to accept this license agreement. Just click on accept and click on finish. Immediately we'll see it is, you know, going to start downloading some of the component. So it's going to take a lot of time, because a lot of things it's going to download and then going to install it. You need to have good amount of bandwidth also, because it's going to download a lot of files and it's going to take some time also. So let's wait for some time, and by the time it get installed, I'll also request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax, So here also regularly I am posting lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. Along with, you can also watch our WordPress videos. So some videos are 1 hour, some videos are 1 hour 30 minute video. So you can watch all these videos on our channel for completely free. So basically you can watch this entire playlist. Alright, so all these links I am going to provide on our channel description. And here let's wait for a couple of minutes. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see it is rightly downloaded all of its components. So you can see our Android SDK is also updated. So everything is fine. Just simply click on finish. So that will launch welcome to Android Studio window over here. So let's just maximize it. And here just simply click on this new project. So that will open this new project window. From here you can select whichever activity that you'd like to launch. For the time being, I'm going to select a very simple empty activity. In my coming videos, I'm going to talk about all these different other activities like navigation drawer views, game activity, responsive views activity and all that. Alright, so in my coming videos, I'm going to discuss about all that. For the time being, I'm going to select just empty activity and going to click on next. So here you need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as Hello Geeky Script, and it's going to automatically set our package name as well over here. So you can see Hello Geeky Script is actually set. First it is com.example and then Hello Geeky Script, and this is where our project is going to be saved. And here minimum SDK version is, you can clearly see API 24, so it's going to support about 97.4% of the devices. So if you switch to some latest version, so let's say API 31, that is Android version 12, you can see very limited amount of Android devices are there. So very limited amount of device, the app that you are going to build will be supported. So that's why it's recommended to select something in middle. I mean, do not make very old or do not make very latest. All right, so you can choose something middle. So let's go with Nougat and just simply click on finish. So that's going to start creating our project. You can see it is slightly started creating. So let's just maximize it. So you can see it is slightly started importing some of the packages. So again, it's going to take some time. You can click on the show all and you can see that it is downloading our Gradle and going to import that. So again, it's going to take some time. So let's wait for some more time over here. And you can see that our project is actually opened over here. So it's going to import some of the packages. So you can see it is importing. So you need to wait for some more time over here. So you can see that it is showing the sync is taking significant amount of time to download some of the dependencies. So this is totally normal, alright. So just give some time and have some patience. By the time it gets installed, I just wanted to mention that I am using i3, alright, and 8 GB of memory. So in this configuration itself, I can run Android Studio for completely fine. So you don't need to worry. You can use your i3 system itself for running Android Studio. You don't need i5, always. So just wanted to mention about that. And now it started indexing. Again, you can see it is updating, indexing, setting up the configurations. So again, wait for some more time over here. And there you go. So you can see, finally it is done. So our app is also rightly over here. So if you expand this app, you will get manifest and Kotlin plus Java. So expand this and you will get this package com.example.hellogeekyscript that we have created. So if you expand this again, you will get this mainactivity.kt. So that exact same file is opened over here. So here is our code. So here if you see, first we have a hello and then we are getting a parameter called name and it is printing this Android. So hello Android is what it's going to print on our app. So if you change this Android to something like Geeky Script and just save this file, and when you're going to run this, it's going to show you this Hello Geeky Script output right on our Android app. So first, you need to do some configurations on your Android phone. So just go to settings on your Android phone and go to My Phone, then Version Info, and then you will get build number. Keep on clicking this build number. You can see now three step away, two step away from being a developer, and finally it will ask you to provide your pattern. So I'll provide my pattern, and you can see the message clearly shown, you are now a developer. So in this way, you need to enable your developer mode first on your phone. So by clicking this build number 5 or 6 times, it's going to show you that option, and that's how you enable your developer option on your phone. So it is very important to enable developer option on your phone. And once you've done that, just go to system and you will get this developer options enabled over here. So you need to click on that, and that will open this use developer options. So you can see it is right enabled, so totally fine. Now you need to scroll down and you need to enable this USB debugging. So enable that, click on OK. So once you do that, it's going to use your phone as a developer options, and also it's going to enable USB debugging. So you are now good to install any Android app from your Android Studio. So only thing that you need to do now is you need to connect your phone with a USB device with your laptop. So just do that. I'm currently doing that. Once you do that, once you connect your USB with your laptop, immediately it will show you this pop-up. So just check this option and click on allow. And you need to also enable your file transfer. So just enable this file transfer. So you need to enable your file transfer, and then you need to allow USB debugging. Immediately it will show you the setup over here, and on your Android Studio it's going to show you your phone over here. You can see it is directly showing over here, right? In Phoenix, the phone that I'm currently using. You can also use Wi-Fi, so you need to be connect on same Wi-Fi network, and you can through Wi-Fi you can send the build version of this app right on your phone. So I'm going to discuss about that on my next videos. For now, let's start with USB. So it is actually done. So just simply click on this run button, and immediately we'll see it's actually started building our project. So once when it gets successfully built, it's going to install our app right on your Android phone. So you can always click on the show all, and you can see what it is doing. So it is first compiling and then going to build it, and you can see that our compiling is rightly done. It is rightly started building and running our project. So let's wait for some more time, and you can see that our Gradle build is rightly finished, and right on your phone you can see the output, hello Geeky Script. So whatever you have written over here, so first hello it is coming, and then Geeky Script, so that exact same thing is coming over here. So you can add some more text over here. So you can just add something like I love pizzas, and then just simply click on this run app, and you'll see it going to again start building our project. This time it will be a little quicker, and you can get that output again also coming on our phone, right? So hello Geeky Script, I love pizzas. Alright, so in this way you can easily install latest version of Android Studio, and you can use your Android phone itself for running Android apps right on your phone itself. So in my next videos, I'm going to talk about more about all these different project layouts that we can use. So starting from this bottom navigation view activity, then this navigation drawer views, all that including game activity on my next videos. So don't forget to subscribe your channel, and also press that bell button to get notified. And if you have faced any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. I'm always there to help you. And also don't forget to subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax along with Geeky Script. And also if you're interested, you can always watch our WordPress videos on our channel for completely free. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. Alright, so that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this.